It will be useful to look more closely at the structure of most scholarly articles. This will help you know where to look in an article and find different kinds of information. Recall that empirical articles communicate the results of scientific experiments. Most empirical articles follow this basic structure. Abstract. The author offers an overview of the article, which often includes their findings. Introduction and literature review. The authors explain their reasons for doing the study and explain where the study fits into the discipline or field. Method. The authors describe their research method or what they did to collect their data. Results. The authors describe the statistics or other methods that they used to analyze their data or results. Discussion or conclusion. The authors discuss the implications of their results, both in terms of their original research questions or hypotheses, and more broadly. If the experimental findings either support or contradict prevailing scientific theories, it'll be discussed here. References. These are the sources that the author used while writing an article. You might also find them useful. Now that you know more about the structure of scholarly articles, here are some strategies for reading and understanding them more quickly and efficiently. Don't read the article from start to finish in your first attempt. Read strategically instead. Hop around to different sections of the article as needed. Read the title and abstract to get a big picture sense of the article's main points. Starting with the title might seem very basic, but you can get some preliminary information from them. Most scholarly articles have titles that have colons. They have subtitles to the right of the colon. To the left of the colon is the attention grabber. Keep in mind that the primary audience is scholars with expertise in the field, so don't be surprised if that part doesn't really grab your attention. To the right of the colon is typically more straightforward and offers an explanation of what the article is about, and sometimes even tells you the method that the author used to conduct his or her study. These two titles provide examples of how you can get information from titles. The first one mentions correlates and patterns, so it's pretty clear that the researchers have some data to share in the article. In the second title, discourse analysis is used, so it sounds like the researcher analyzed some writing to draw conclusions. The abstract gives a broad overview, usually in one paragraph, of what the author will cover in the full article. It can tell you the main problem or question, the approach or method the author used to answer the questions or problems, and what the new contributions are offered by the author that explain why professionals and scholars in the field should care. Read the introduction to get a sense of what the researchers were hoping to find and what they wanted to add to our knowledge of the topic. You'll usually find a kind of thesis statement at the end of the introduction. The literature review can give you the background of the scholarly conversation about the topic. It helps the reader understand where this article fits with the established knowledge of the field. After the introduction, jump to the discussion. Read the discussion section carefully to learn why the researchers think the results are important. This is also where authors usually identify the limitations of their work so that we don't overinterpret. After reading the introduction and discussion, you'll have a better understanding of the main idea of the article. You can get a good sense of what the research is all about without reading the methods or results sections in depth. Read the methods section closely if you need detailed information on how the experiment was conducted or the materials used in the experiment. Read the results section closely if you want to find out more about how the data was collected during the experiment and how it was statistically analyzed. If your assignment is to critique or analyze an article, you will need to read the method and results sections closely. Pay attention to headings, subheadings, charts, and figures to get an overall sense of the article.